took my kids to an NBA game in Boston when we were out there for a bar mitzvah, Peter. My 8 and 6 year old, they loved it. Will they be watching an NBA game through VR? I mean, is that what the future is here? Do you think when we start watching games in virtual reality, in your mind?
I don't think, without being presumptuous, I don't think that's the right way to frame the question.
Okay.
I think the question is, audiences consume entertainment in different ways. You know, some watch highlights at the end, some watch just the television show which talks about it, some watch the game, some go to the game, and they can all be fans in different ways. There's nothing that's better than being at a game, breathing the same air, being in the room with the athletes, and playing. But only 18,000 people can be in there. Mm-hmm. Only 18,000. Count them. 18,000. So if you could virtually be there, and you're living in Spain, or you're living, if you want to see the Boston Celtics, and you're living in San Diego, going there is a burden. You can watch it on television. You can listen it on the radio. You can stream it on your mobile device. But this is just another way of consuming the content. Another way. It's not the only way. It is a terrific way. And it's an adjunct to television broadcasts. It's an adjunct to radio broadcasts. It's an adjunct to being there. It's different. It's virtually being there. The difference is real, though. The difference is real. Because in all of the other methods, it's a curated product. The Rich Eisen says, here's what's going on. Look at this. And the director cuts to that. And the director cuts to this. And there's a commercial break. And then you have somebody talking about the halftime. When you go to the game, you are the director, the producer, the writer. You are narrating the game yourself. You are actually more of a participant than a passenger. And that's what virtual reality does for you. It puts you in the driver's seat virtually. You're sitting next to the scorer's table, and you're watching it from that perspective, and you're looking around, seeing the fans. You're seeing everything that's going on. You're consuming and experiencing the product in a unique and different way. This is a resource and a tool. Will it replace television? Absolutely not. Will it replace going to the game? Absolutely not. Will it bring more fans globally and even nationally to enjoy another kind of experience with an NBA product, a team product? Absolutely. And I think it will only encourage them to go to the game, to watch it on television, because those are different experiences. So we need an organization, the NBA, or a team like the Warriors, we need to be digitally fit. We can't afford in this world today to be an incumbent. We got to be a challenger to our own incumbency. We got to look at things, try new things, and some will work and some will won't. If we don't try any new thing, we won't work one day.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.